If you have ever got any value from a video that I've recorded, then I want you to do me one favor, please. Watch today's video all the way through to the end. Because some of you are gonna get halfway through and think, look, Bryce, I can see where you're going with this, but this is just not for me. Do me one favor and watch this video through to the end. This is without a doubt the most important video that I've ever created and probably ever will. I've been thinking about this. I've been thinking about nothing else for a month. Watch this video through to the end. There's been a lot of news coverage here in Australia on the 2021 United Nations Climate Change Conference, COP26. And it's been pretty good. A lot of governments around the world have been signing up to and committing to achieving net zero by 2050. The thing is, the two things I've been wondering about the last month, most days really, is one, I don't think that governments know how to get there. Not necessarily a criticism, it's good that we're making a commitment to try and do something, but you know, I don't think governments know how to get there. And secondly, you know, governments do not have a great track record of getting important things done. And I've been thinking about this probably every day for, I don't know, 4 to 6 weeks or so. And it just hit me really hard the other day that we, as the building management system industry, are so well placed to be a part of the solution. Because we don't need hundreds and hundreds of kilometers of wind turbines, and we don't need millions and millions of solar panels. We don't need the billions of dollars and the trillions of dollars of investment and funding to build all of that. We don't need any of that. Because in all the big cities around the world, in every country, thousands and thousands of buildings, we have building management systems, building control systems in those buildings already. The infrastructure already exists. And we are already doing BMS maintenance in those buildings. So we are going to those buildings every day and doing something, and we're getting paid to be there. So essentially there's a financial engagement already between us and the building owners in hundreds of thousands of buildings all around the world. And all we need is one thing. This is what we need. I'm gonna show it to you. This is called a bag. I'm gonna open this bag and show you an energy efficiency tool, a carbon reducing tool. This is very exciting. This is a tool that every single BMS service technician already has. Let me show you how it works. You open this flap. And you tap on here like this. There's a button on the side here, it's called the enter button. When I hit that enter button, this is what happens. Smarter control strategies go down into millions of field controllers around the world. Every time I hit that enter button, fans slow down slightly. Pumps slow down slightly. Chillers draw a little bit less electrical power. Boilers use a little bit less gas. Cooling valves slightly close, and heating valves. Damper actuators close slightly. We don't need anything else. We have the buildings with the infrastructure already installed. We don't need to install millions of miles of power cables to charge electric cars. We don't need any of that stuff. We have the infrastructure ready. We're already going there every day and already been paid to go there every day. And we have the tools. Now imagine if you went to the building owner and said this to them. Hello, Mr. Building Owner. It is so great to see you again. The industry is opening back up again. Listen here, we saw this amazing YouTube video and we're gonna change how we do maintenance for the next 1 year, maybe 2 years. This is what we're gonna do. So for the past 1 year, 2 year, 3 years, 10 years, whatever it was, in the past, we have been coming to your building and doing maintenance. We've been checking valve actuators and damper actuators and checking sensors and controllers. And we've been keeping your building running really healthily and operating, you know, effectively. So we checked all those things last year. The valves, the actuators, we checked them. They all worked. We fixed a few last year. This year, they are highly likely to still be working. So what we want to do is we want to take our entire 12-month preventative maintenance contract, the whole thing, you know, $50,000 a year or $100,000 a year. We're going to allocate the entire budget to control strategy optimization and energy efficiency. We're going to put preventative maintenance on hold for 12 months, maybe 2 years. So you're not going to see service technicians come to site and walk around and look for broken things. We're not going to do that. We're going to focus every single man day and every man hour on control strategy optimization and energy efficiency. That's what we're gonna do. So you might not see us for the first 2 or 3 months in January, February, March, because we're gonna redesign the control strategies. Then we're gonna program the control strategies. Then we'll come to start, download the control strategies and do tuning and optimization and work through the program. Do you know what your customer's gonna say? The building owner's gonna say, what? Are you saying that for no extra money, my building's energy efficiency rating is gonna improve? And you'll say, yep. But like, do you mean that for no extra money, my utility bills, my electricity, my gas bill is just gonna come down a little bit? For no extra money? And you'll go, yep, that's what we're gonna do. Your customer's gonna be very, very happy with you. And I don't see why we shouldn't do this. You can say to them, look, after 1 year, maybe in year two or halfway through year two, we'll sort of come back a little bit and we'll start catching up on our preventative maintenance. But just for 1 year, we're gonna focus our entire budget on control strategy optimization. No customer in the world is gonna say to you, nah, don't do that. Rather come to site, walk around, look for broken things, and then charge me more money to fix them. No one's gonna say that. So we have the tools. We have the time because we're already going to site. That's already happening. And we have the money. We're already getting paid to do the work. So like, what's holding us back? What's stopping us from doing all the heavy lifting towards net zero in the next 2 or 3 years? What is stopping us? Comment down below if you can think of a roadblock. Let's try and sort that out. So the two things that we need still, other than the tools, the time, the money, is the first thing is I will teach you how to do it. So if you join me on this net zero journey, from next year, all of our videos will be dedicated to control strategy optimization. I will give you the control strategies. I will give you my intellectual property for free, and I will teach you how to do it. The one thing we don't have, and the one thing that I can't sort out, is my reach is only this big. So those of you that are watching this video, there's not thousands of people that watch these videos. There's the YouTube channel and there's LinkedIn. I don't have enough reach. If 200 people jump in on this, great. We'll save energy in some individual buildings, but there will not be a significant, noticeable impact on the planet. So what I need you to do is to help me get more reach. So if all of you sort of forward this video to all your buddies and we try get more reach and get thousands of BMS service technicians together, I'm telling you now, there is nothing, I don't think is anything stopping us from doing this. I can't think of anything stopping us. Now here's the important piece, or sort of important piece, is apparently, I'm not an expert in this, but to get to net zero by 2050, apparently we have to halve our global greenhouse gas emissions by 2030. I don't even know what that means, but I do know that to halve anything worldwide in 8 years is somewhere between very difficult and impossible. So I just think that while governments are talking about this and getting money together and building solar panel farms and all this stuff and doing this stuff, I think that we need to do the heavy lifting in the next 1, 2, 3 years, because we don't need anything. We don't need anybody else to give us something. We don't need billions of dollars and trillion dollars of money. We just need to try. That's all we have to do. We just need to try. I will tell you how to do it. You just have to help me do it. So for me, I do my bit here and there. I care about the environment. I'm not like full on into this. Like, I drive a 3.6 liter V6 petrol Jeep. That thing, you can tell how fast you're going by how fast the petrol gauge is going down. So I'm not super passionate about this. I'm not like, you know, like, I don't go to demonstrations and things. My driver here is that I just don't think that we can just ignore this. I feel that we have an obligation to not look away. And it wouldn't be disappointing, but it would be disgusting if we, being so well placed in the world, to actually make a very fast change very quickly. I think that that would be disgusting if we just look away. Because we haven't been doing a great job the last 20 years, and now is our opportunity to make a real big difference. And it's not going to be that hard. It actually will probably be fun to do this. If you're in, comment down below, I am in. If you're a building owner, comment down below, me and my building are in. If you're a branch manager or an ops manager, whatever you are, you comment, me and my team are in. If you feel uncomfortable commenting in YouTube, I don't like it, then like this video, but you have to send an email and forward this to at least 2 people. Because remember, I don't have the reach to do this. I don't have the reach to do this. It'll be a waste of time. I need you to help me share this video with as many people in the world that you can. If you're a building owner, share the video, because you're the BMS company, they work for you and they might not have seen this video, so share it with them. If you're a mechanical contractor, you're doing maintenance on buildings as well. You're a piece of the puzzle. And a lot of the times the BMS company is your subcontractor, so get them involved. And even if they're not and they're direct to the owner, you know, still share the video. Mechanical consultants, sustainability consultants, everybody that works in building services, let's get it out there. I will show you how to do it. I will give you the control strategies. You have the time, you have the money, we have the heart to do it. Thank you for watching, and next year we will start plowing through these videos. Next year, all of our videos are on net zero coordination, not the random stuff I normally do. Thank you for watching.